Why, hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and pets of all ages. You have clicked on a Mr. Golden Sports Madden 25 gameplay. Today, we have some MUT, and we are on the PSFL, bringing you guys some gameplay with the budget squad. And we are 83 overall, the Garcon Goons, going up against a viewer. And the Garcon Goon so far with Gold Cam, knock on wood. I don't got no wood around me, but if anybody got some wood, go ahead and knock on that bad boy one time for you, boy. Just one time. we have yet to lose with Gold Cam. So, you know, he's definitely been putting the team on his back, being able to, you know, be productive offensively. And hopefully that continues. Hopefully we can go on ahead and find success against, you know, a better team. So, definitely, if I can move the ball on the ground, that's going to help out the offense in its entirety. You know, DeMarco Murray is one of my better weapons. A really quick pass right there to none other than Hong Garcon, who has been such an incredible weapon through the year since I've been back again playing on the PlayStation. So right there, just get down. You know, I know he's got some hard hitting safety, so I want to avoid that. Get down. Don't take any type of unnecessary punishment from any of those guys. So 3rd and 7, we back up, and I kind of got baited by the computer right there. As the safety was backing away, I thought I would have had room to go on ahead and just squeeze that pass in there, which I would have had he continued just backpedaling. But he actually just shot forward at the very last second, as right as I was releasing the ball, and got himself an interception. So you know, good job by the CPU baiting me like that. So he's already in prime position, already has a good opportunity to go on ahead and score. Seen that route right there, but I was just a skosh too late. Very next play, inside slant over there towards the left, ends up scoring a touchdown. And that right there is definitely no bueno. He gets ball at halftime, so I'm a little worried that the streak is in jeopardy, you know, because like I said, he gets ball at halftime. So I gotta play this possession very well. You know, clock management is key right here during this possession. Right here, just a quick out route, going ahead and pick up that first down. And as you see, I kind of, you know, got rid of the run a little bit. You know, starting to find some success against him through the air. You know, now I feel like it's a good time. Going ahead and go through the, go on the ground. And DeMarco Murray, 91 elite DeMarco Murray, who is such a glitch. Look at him rumbling, bumbling, stumbling all the way on the 3-yard line. He calls timeouts, you know, obviously knowing I would go on ahead, pull a stool out, put on some gloves, and fiddle with them udders, baby. Fiddle with them udders and milk him. But, you know, he does a smart decision, calls a timeout, and I do end up scoring on that very next play. So he has about a minute and some change remaining, and that's a lot of time in Madden. If you guys, you know, play Madden, you guys know you see a minute left with a couple timeouts. Definitely more than enough time for you to drive downfield and, you know, make it a scoring drive. You know, since him getting ball at halftime, I'm definitely not feeling good. I'm not feeling confident. But right there, don't test the user. He is so disrespectful, though. Huge interception. As I was saying before, we went ahead and sprinkled in our defensive catch radar. Whoop! Quick inside pass right there to none other than Garcon. The fact that I wasn't feeling confident, he's getting ball at halftime. You know, he has the chance to be able to drive down, score at minimum a field goal, maybe even a touchdown, then go up multiple possessions coming out of half. So, you know, to avoid all that was definitely huge. Being able to go on ahead and get ourselves a turnover and score ourselves was definitely a huge shift in momentum. You know, now no matter what, you know, we should be going into halftime with the lead. So that right there, you know, definitely puts my confidence up on being able to go on ahead and take this game home. Right there, he calls his last timeout. Couple seconds remaining. Thankfully, he dropped that, only leaving 8 seconds left. So he decides to go over there towards the right side, and he drops another pass. His guys are just not being able to hold on to these catches after contact, which is, you know, good for me. I hope they continue to drop them. So up 14-7 going into halftime. You know, the game plan is definitely focusing on offense. We could go tit for tat all day right here. You know, fine by me. You know, I always feel more confident that if somebody's going to make a mistake between the two of us, it's going to be you first. So, you know, if he scores, that's fine. You know, it's up to my offense here. You know, as long as I continue to keep scoring when I get the ball, I feel like eventually I can go on ahead and get you to make just one mistake eventually. So right there, huge catch over there on the right side by A.J. Green. Just chucks it up, and my defender just had nothing to even try. And like, I don't know. He didn't try and do anything. He didn't do anything. Wow, just nothing. You know, that right there is a situation where after that happens, you're like, dang it, I should have clicked on and try and swat it down. You know, because in situations like that where it looks like it's an obvious bat down situation, I'll let the computer handle it. To my surprise, he punted the ball right there. And I don't know if he's feeling really confident on defense or if he wasn't feeling confident enough offensively. Nonetheless, we did, you know, get ourselves a turnover on downs, which is big for us because now we have an opportunity to go on ahead and, you know, get it, even if it's just a field goal, it's a two possession game. Right there, beautiful touch pass right there. If I threw a bullet pass, it most likely would have been an interception because he was kind of trailing. Not close enough, but he was definitely there where if I threw a bullet, he might have been able to jump it. But because we did that law pass, which I knew he wasn't expecting.